Hey, this is John with Circuit Board Medics. We're here to show you how to remove the turbo actuator from the Cummins 6.7 diesel engine. These are out of 2007 to 2018 Ram trucks. Today we're working on a 2010 Ram 3500 with a Cummins 6.7 diesel engine. We're going to be removing and replacing the turbo actuator off of the HE351 turbo. Before unbolting the turbo actuator, it's very important to drain the coolant from the system. The easiest way to get to the turbo actuator is through the front passenger wheel well. We'll start by jacking up the vehicle and removing the passenger side front wheel, and then we can remove the inner fender splash guard. Now that the wheel has been removed, the next step is to remove the inner fender liner. We will remove the fasteners starting with the 8mm heads here. With two more in recesses above. And there are three push clips located here. And one push tab for a wiring harness behind the liner. Now that the liner's been removed, we can gain access to the turbo actuator. On the HE351, the wiring harness is built into the housing of the actuator, so you'll need to follow the wiring to find the plug. You'll unlock the plug by removing a red tab, pressing down on the release clip, and separating the connector. Once the connector is unplugged, remove the four bolts holding the turbo actuator to the turbo. They are 5mm Allens. There are two shorter bolts on top and two longer bolts on the bottom. When removing the turbo actuator from the turbo housing itself, you want to pry the bottom off first so that any residual coolant doesn't get into the turbo actuator. I have a new turbo here to show you the sector gear. Once you pull the actuator off, you want to make sure that your sector gear travels fully. You'll hear it click to either side. It travels about an inch. If it's bound up or not moving easily with just the push of a finger in either direction, you may need a new turbo. To verify that your sector gear travels fully in both directions, you'll be able to line up the guide hole with two holes in the body of the turbo. Other versions of this turbo will have guide marks here to indicate full travel, and here. Before reinstalling the turbo actuator, it's important to make sure that the sector gear is rotated fully clockwise. Also, before reinstalling the turbo actuator, you want to make sure that the surface areas for the seals are clean and flat. We recommend using either Scotch-Brite or razor blade or both. Anytime this turbo actuator is replaced, it needs to be calibrated upon installation. Here at Circuit Board Medics, we've developed a standalone calibrator that takes the place of much more expensive scan tools. We'll start by connecting the standalone calibrator to the vehicle by installing the black cable and the other end to the vehicle harness. The next step is to power on the calibrator by turning the ignition on without starting the engine. The calibrator will then power on, and we'll press begin to start the calibration procedure. Next, we're going to plug the red cable into the actuator and the other end into the actuator port on the calibrator. The next step, we'll lock the device to the VIN of the truck that you're working on. And the next step after that is to move the sector gear to the install position, which is the clockwise most position. The next step prepares the actuator for calibration and aligns the gear in the actuator. Once you reach step four, it's time to mount the actuator. Before doing so, make sure that the seals are fully seated, the sealing surfaces are cleaned, and the actuator gear and sector gear are greased with the lube provided. Torque the actuator mounting bolts to 8 foot-pounds in a crisscross pattern. Now that the actuator is mounted, it's time to calibrate it with the final step. Now that the calibration is successful, we can turn the ignition off. Next, we will remove the calibration tool and plug the harness back into the actuator. Now we're reinstalling the fender liner. Lastly, put the wheel back on. After the turbo actuator is installed and calibrated, the next step is to refill and bleed the cooling system. We hope this video has been helpful. If you need a turbo actuator from an HE351 or an HE300, visit our website at circuitboardmedics.com or give us a call at 800-547-2049. Also check out our full lineup of turbos, turbo actuators, injectors, instrument clusters, and tippums for other Ram trucks. We look forward to serving all of your automotive electronic needs.